नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स वन एंड ऑल लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, लेट मी टेक दिस सब्जेक्ट मच फर्दर विथ अ व्यू ऑफ प्रेजेंटिंग द वेरी conceptual understanding and the very understanding about what these shastras are all about. Because so far I was speaking about consciousness and various other aspects. In fact, I have started this project with taking Natya Shastra with a view of interpretation of shastras at various levels. So maybe this could be the ideal launch pad of understanding Natya Shastra from the Hinduism point of view. Today, if I really see it, there was one very interesting point which Shashi Tharoor raised about Hinduism, the secularistic and fundamentalistic point of view. The very concept of Hinduism started maybe way back around Dravidian culture, or even much before that, or even when the Indic or Indus Valley civilization existed, or Harappa Mohenjo-daro existed. As I was telling, Natya Shastra has the practical relevance of Nasadiya Sukta and Hiranyagarbha Sukta, which is very much neither the universe existed nor it can be destroyed. At the same time, atom and subatoms in the universe, neither they exist, but they exist. They exist and they cannot die. At the same time, there is a concept that they do not exist also. Now, if I really look at these very concepts, the religion aspect also comes into picture. Caste, creed, and other aspects also come into picture. But the very point of Hinduism, or the focal point of the Hinduism, is all about Ekoham Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Tat Vam Asi, Though That I. Now, was this very hard for people to understand in simple language when the universe existed, or when the universe was expanding during the period of Nasadiya Sukta or Hiranyagarbha Sukta, is one question that one needs to ask. Here, there is one more question that one needs to ask. Kasmai Devaya Havisha Videma. Who is that God? Kasmai Devaya. How are you defining God? Does he have form? Is he form or is he formless? The reason for getting this into the notice of the scholars or the research scholars or the dancers or the individuals who are looking into Vedas and Upanishads is whole of the Shastra is nothing without Kasmai Devaya Havisha Vidhema. Whole of the Shastras. Because in Natya Shastra or in the dance form, you depict a god who is having form, not the formless kind of thing that you are exhibiting there. The only formless thing that you are exhibiting is emotions, that emotional intelligence of the mind, body and soul as an individual. This is one very critical point that one needs to understand. As Shashi Tharoor said, if I really go back to the same question, Kasmai Devaya Havisha Videma, there is always like, who is that God? Is he Nirguna Brahma or the Brahman? Or Brahma? Or Brahma? The point is, this one very concept triggered the very ideology of creating that awareness among the individuals. That's the beauty of this Shastras or Vedas or Upanishads. Though people say Bharata wrote Natya Shastra, I would say it is a compilation of various texts. From the Shrutis, which have been translated to Smritis, which further got transcribed to 36 chapters with various conceptual understanding, creating this, creating that. I do not want to get into that right now. I will get into that later stages. Agama Shastra came later. Now, the point is, all of these Shastras which we are talking about, it's very much dependent on Ekoham Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Brahma Tattva, Brahma Tattva, Brahman consciousness. And consciousness at the highest level. Now, how do one get to this point? Is what was the question that came to the mind of the seers or the sages. Definitely yes, they would have existed. If human being has existed as an individual, definitely sages would have existed. For sure, yes. He was like us only. But far higher level of understanding of the subjective knowledge. Now the point is, the very question of why these seers, sages, rishis, Brahma rishis, Sapta rishis are talking about Brahma, Brahma, Brahman and Kasmai Devaya Havisha Videma. Why should they be talking about it? There has to be some motive behind that, right? We define that as a modern day, as Hinduism cult. With certain principles and certain actions laid down towards the betterment of the human society, where there is only one concept called unity and diversity. There is only one God. There are no caste or creed. There is no caste difference there. All are same. All are one. Unfortunately, as the centuries passed away, as the days or years passed, from first millennium century to 21st century to this day, the very concept of Hinduism is getting exploited in a negative way. In the very Natyashastra, which was supposed to be propagating the Hinduism or the Hindu cult or the Hindu culture, religion doesn't mean I am from Muslim, I am from Christianity, I am from Brahmin, etc. Religion means over here, what is that you are practicing? This is what was there. And this is what is the primary aim of Natya Shastra to depict. And this is the final outcome of the dance form. Forget about whether gods existed or not. Around 3,36,000 living beings created. How do you show that discrimination? And this is where the fundamentalism and secularism of the religious aspects came. And we have forgotten our roots. Maybe yes. That we are taking the form God, the God that has form. Whether the God is having the form or not, that's a different aspect for people. We say God is like this because as the centuries and as the periods passed away, as the years passed away, there has to be some reference, right? Some cross reference to whatever that we are speaking. So what the rishis and munis, Brahma rishis did was created mythological stories. If people say Ravana had 10 heads, can he really exhibit that? What really these 10 heads are? One needs to get into that. Did Sri Krishna really exhibit that Vishwarupa to Arjuna in the middle of battlefield? Yes, he would have. He had, in fact. That talks about Srishti Laya Jati Gati. And if people say no one can view, no one had other than the realized souls, there itself you are getting an answer of this Vishwarupa. Think about it. It's an open-ended question. Like this, if we take, there are various examples. Our Hinduism as such is based on the university in diversity, unity in diversity as such, which is what was the primary reason for Natya Shastra to come into existence. They wherein we are we have what you call various authors have been showing that using the mythological stories, myth plus theology, whether they existed or not, that's a different aspect. If they really existed, yes, they would have. To share an anecdote for this, when I was reading Adi Shankaracharya's books, there is a common, there is a, one what you call notion that Adi Shankaracharya, before taking the renunciation, there is a pond where there is a crocodile which wanted to eat Adi Shankaracharya's legs. But mother was not allowing. I wanted to see that pond where Adi Shankaracharya got that permission from his mother. You can go now. And I wanted to see his place, where exactly he was. If I really looked at, when I asked him, do you really think that is existing? He was correct. This was way back around 6 years back when I went to college. Likewise, I wanted to really see if really God speaks or not, and feel that enlightenment. Without even getting into the dance form or the classical art form or the music form, before even getting to that, I wanted to see that, and I was doing the various kinds of meditational practices and yoga practices for that. What I have understood was, everything is within you. Who is that one person within you who takes control over that? It's your thought, and it's your practices. It's your rituals that you do on a daily basis. Thinking good about others. Yat bhavam tat bhavati. Now, this is where whole of the Natya Shastra is revolving around. If you really closely observe, it more or less talks about Sanatana Dharma's basic principles, basic factors, or the cofactors, pointers that lead one to get to a betterment, better stage. Next to what you call near to perfection personality. The point is, how do we understand this? Is it with the form God with the god that you are taking, that it has forms, hands, legs, etc.? Or is it that Nirguna Brahma? Are we talking about Saguna Brahma or Nirguna Brahma over here? This is where fundamentalistic and the secularistic way of taking the dharma aspect comes into picture. Thanks to Dr. Shashi Tharoor getting this point in his book. The point is, how do you really look at it is what matters. Thus, this leaves as an open-ended question to the scholars or the research scholars who are doing their research work of finding the proper definition of Hinduism. And in fact, Natya Shastra is all about like bringing out the true definition of Hinduism. True definition. When I say true definition, which one needs to really get to understand from the Nirguna Brahma point of view, Brahman point of view, from Kasmai Devaya Harishabhidema, from Nasriya Sutta, Ekoham Brahma. Think about it. Are we trying to exploit Natya Shastra or implore Natya Shastra? Are we trying to explore by exploiting the subject, by getting into the roots of the thing from the viewpoint of Nirguna or Saguna Brahma, Brahman consciousness, where casteism does not come into picture, religion also does not come into picture? There the religion definition is what you are practicing, what you are doing. Think about it. It's an open-ended question to scholars and research scholars. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. May the Guru's grace be with one and all. Have a nice day ahead.